Swayam Prabha, Digital India, Educated India.
Hello dear students, I am Dr. Mona Semalti from HNB Garhwal University, Srinagar, Garhwal. So dear students, I welcome you all in this module, and today in this module we are going to discuss about powders. So after going through from this module, you will be able to know about, this is our learning outcome. After going through from this module, you will be able to know about what are powders, what are advantages, disadvantages, different types of particle size and effect of particle size, classification, methods of blending and problems encountered in powder formulation. Okay. So moving to now introduction to powders. See, pharmaceutical powder, it is a mixture of finely divided drug or chemicals in a dry form and are used internally or externally. Okay, so let me explain you, like a powder you might have seen solid particles in amorphous form or in crystalline form. Okay, so this basically forms an background, or we can say this basically forms that all the pharmaceutical doses form. If we take example of tablet, capsules, so they are made up of active ingredient plus the additives which we use. Okay, so basically powder is a mixture of finely divided drug and chemicals in a dry form, and they are available in crystalline and amorphous form, and they are the one of the oldest type of doses form in pharmaceuticals. Now what are the advantages? Okay, so advantages of powders: powders are more stable than liquid doses form, and chances of incompatibility are less as compared to liquid doses form. Okay, incompatibility means these powders are more compatible with the other ingredients which we mix. Okay, so patient compliance, it is one of the major advantage in case of children and elderly patients, and the onset of action of the powder is quick as compared to the tablet and capsules, because the powder is in we can say it is in, the particle size of the powder is very less. Okay, so the when the particle size is less, the exposed surface area is more, and it is going to get dissolved very quickly as compared to the tablet and capsule, the other solid doses form. Okay. Next advantage of powder is that large quantity of powder can be administered to the patient orally by dissolving or mixing the powder in a suitable liquid. And they are more economical as compared to the other dosage forms, and the smaller particle size, it facilitates the dissolution, as I said, and then absorption and the bioavailability. Okay, so now Disadvantages of powder. Okay, the drugs which are having bitter, nauseous, and unpleasant taste cannot be dispensed in the form of powder. Deliquescent and hygroscopic drugs, which absorbs or which catches moisture, cannot be dispensed in powder form. So this is disadvantage of powder doses form. And drugs which get affected by atmospheric conditions are not suitable. And dispensing of powder, it is a time consuming process. Now, particle size. Dear students, particle size, it plays a very important role in overall absorption, bioavailability, and dissolution of powder doses form, you say, or you can also understand if when we talk about tablet doses form. So the particle size of the granules there also, it plays an important role. So overall particle size is going to affect your absorption, bioavailability, and dissolution. So USP classifies the powder very coarse, coarse, moderate coarse, fine, and very fine. So now we will see what all the particle size of powders. Very coarse. Okay, a very coarse powder, all the particle passes through number 8 sieve, and not more than 20% passes through in number 60 sieve. So this is definition of very coarse powder. Coarse powder, all the particles passes through the sieve number 20, and not more than 40% passes through a sieve number 60. Moderate coarse, all the particle passes through sieve number 40, and not more than 40% passes through sieve number 80. So this is the classification, it is as per USP. So just go through from it and fine particle and very fine particles. All particles passes through number sieve number 60, and not more than 40% passes through sieve number 100. Okay, very fine, all the particle passes through a sieve size number 80, and there is no limit to greater fineness. So this is about the different sizes of particle size of powder. So coarse, very coarse, fine, very fine. So this is how we classify it. Now, what is the effect of particle size on various factors, such as dissolution rate? Okay, so as I told you in the beginning also, that when the particle size is low, or we can say the micronization, can increase the rate of dissolution and its bioavailability. Micronization means reduction of particle size by any mean. So if the particle size is less, absorption is more, surface exposed surface area is more, so it is going to get dissolved faster, and then absorption, and then bioavailability. Okay, so, and next is suspendability. The particles intended to remain undissolved but uniformly dispersed in a liquid vehicle. So this also affects the suspendability. Okay, next is uniform distribution of drug substance in powder mixture or solid doses form to ensure dose to dose content uniformity. Okay, uniform distribution, if the particle size is of same kind, then it is going to distribute uniformly. Penetrability of particles intended to be inhaled for deposition deep in the respiratory tract. So penetrability also is going to govern by the particle size and lack of grittiness. Lack of grittiness of solid particles in dermal ointments, cream, and ophthalmic preparation. If the particle size of the active ingredients and the other additive is not uniform, or if it is less, if it is not uniform particle size, so it is going to affect the grittiness. That means when we will prepare ointment of the same, so there may be a kind of grittiness. So the application will not be smooth in that case. So these are the factors which are going to be affected by the particle size of powder. Now, moving to the preparation of powder. So there are preparation of powder, the very first step is the reduction of particle size, then sieving and weighing of each ingredient, mixing and packaging. So this is as simple. So five steps in the preparation of powder. First is reduction of particle size, of course, and then sieving, and then sieving for getting uniform particle size, then weighing, okay, that is for measuring the each ingredient, then mixing of all, and then finally packing. So this is about the preparation of powders. So now the very first step, that is reduction of particle size. So this is very important. And what are the methods of reduction of particle size? That means, what are the methods by which we are going to reduce the particle size or micronization of the powder? So there are different methods like trituration. Okay, trituration, this is very old method and very commonly adopted method. Like on a small scale, the pharmacist reduces the size of chemical substance by simply grinding in a mortar and pestle. Okay, so finer grinding action is accomplished. It is accomplished by using mortar with a rough surface. So this is one method, and a very traditional method. This is trituration. You might have seen dispensing pharmacies when sometimes also you might have seen in case of tablet the dosage form which were used to prepare for children, so they used to grind the tablet or to get some powder form so that the kids can easily swallow it, or kids can easily swallow it by dissolving in a suitable liquid. Okay, so this is this trituration, which is as I told you, which is a very old method of particle size reduction. Next is pulverization. Okay, now what pulverization is on the large scale? Various types of mills and pulverizers may be used to reduce the particle size. Okay, now substance which are reduced and subdivided with an additional material, say for example a solvent, that can be removed easily after pulverization is complete. That means with the help of any solvent, we reduce the particle size. And different mills and pulverizers are used in this technique. See, for example, alcohol is added to the camphor for reducing it in the form of a fine powder, and later the alcohol is evaporated. Okay, so this way. Third method is levigation. Okay, now what levigation is? A mortar and pestle or an ointment tile may be used. So paste is formed by combining two powder and a small amount of liquid, that is the levigating agent, in which the powder is insoluble. Then paste is then triturated to reduce the particles. So now moving to the blending of powder. Okay, what blending is? When two or more powder substances are to be combined to form a uniform mixture. Okay, so this is blending, and it is the best to reduce the particle size of each powder individually before weighing and blending. So dear students, what blending is? Blending is when we take two powders, okay, two separate powders, and mix them to get a uniform mixture. So what is the best way is to reduce the particle size individually and then mix it, and then weighing and blending. Okay, so it depends that what method we are going to follow for blending, depending on the nature of the ingredient and the amount of the powder and the equipment, and the powder may be blended by various methods, as I told you, speculation, spatulation, simple speculation, trituration and geometric dilution and sifting and tumbling. So these are the methods for blending of powder. Now, very first method we will see, speculation. Speculation is used basically for blending of small amount of powders by a movement of a spatula, simple spatula. You might have seen a spatula in laboratory, right? So spatula we take and it is blended with the help of spatula. That is why it names speculation. So it is not suitable for the large quantity of the powder and the powder which contains potent substances, okay? And because homogeneous blending is not as certain as other methods, so in this you can also call it as a disadvantage of speculation, that we don't get uniform size, a uniform blending we don't get in this method. So next is trituration. Okay, so trituration, it is used for both to comminute and to mix the powder. That means reduce the particle size and then for mixing also. Okay, so if mixture is desired without a special need of reducing the particle size, the glass mortar is usually preferred. Okay, now the third method, it is sifting. Now powder may also be mixed by passing them through a sifter. Like a sifter, like you might have seen, for those we use in kitchen to sift our flour, okay, sieve basically. Okay, so this process is not acceptable for incorporation of the potent drug into a diluent powder. Now next is tumbling. Okay, now what tumbling is? In another method of mixing the powder, tumbling of the powder in a rotating chamber. Special small scale or large scale motorized powder blender or mixed powder is mixed powders by tumbling them. So mixing by this process is thorough, but it is very time consuming. That means the tumbling is very good method of blending of the powder, but it takes a lot of time. Now last method, it is geometrical dilution. So this is the process. So dear student, this is very important and it may be asked in the examination in short note, like write a short note on geometric dilution. So geometric dilution, basically it is a process by which the homogeneous mixture or even distribution of two or more substances is achieved. And this method is used when potent substances must be mixed with large amount of diluent. Okay, so great care is needed always when we handle potent substances. A potent drug and approximately equal volume of diluents are placed in a mortar and it is thoroughly mixed by trituration, and the second portion of the diluent equal in volume to the powder is mixture is added to the mortar, and then trituration is repeated and so on. Okay, and this process is continued. So equal volumes of diluents are added to the powder mixture in a mortar until all the diluent is incorporated. So this is what is geometric dilutions. Okay, so you can take you can refer the textbooks for example. So you can take any example of geometrical dilutions for blending of powders. Now I'm directly moving to the classification of powder. So classification of powder, we can classify them based on their uses, for internal use, for external use and special purpose powder. For internal use, okay, divided powder, simple powder, compound powder, sachet, tablet triturates, bulk powder, antacid and laxatives. This is for internal use. Okay, now external use, dusting powder, medicated dusting powder and surgical dusting powder, and insufflations, okay, Dauch powder and dentifrices. These are for external use. And now special powders, those are eutectic mixture and effervescent powder. So this is about the classification of powders. Simple powder, moving to next, simple powder, I'll just tell you little about simple powder. Simple powder, it contains only one ingredient, either in crystalline form or in amorphous form. Okay, two forms, amorphous form and crystalline form. Now what is the difference between these two forms? Amorphous form is having the coarse fine particle size, and crystalline form, the particle size, it is in the form of crystalline form. Okay, so always there are two forms, so you must know the difference between these two, amorphous and crystalline, always. Okay, so simple powder, it contains, as I said, one ingredient either in crystalline form or in amorphous form. If powder present in crystalline form, then it is to be reduced to the finer powder, in fine powder. That means the crystalline form is to be blended, and for reduction in particle size, weight, the powder, and divided into number of doses and wrapped as individual dose. So this is simple powder. Procedure for simple powder is, if you want to prepare a powder of aspirin, like powder, powder the aspirin and weigh the required quantity of aspirin, and say for example 300 mg of aspirin for each powder, and wrap the powder in individual powder paper, and you can write there that the direction, one powder to be taken after every 8 hours. So this is basically, let me tell you, a traditional way of dispensing and compounding. Nowadays, this kind of doses form, I can say, the powder kind, doses form are not administered in a powder form, basically. Okay. So, anyways, next is compound powder. Compound powder contains two or more substances which are mixed together, right? Two or more substances mixed together. They are divided into desired number of individual doses and then dispensed into each powder paper. Okay, you can take any example. Okay, so I am not giving any example here. Now moving to next, which is dusting powder, right? Dusting powder, these are used for external application on the skin and generally applied in a very fine state to avoid the local irritation. You might have seen when you use of dusting powder sometimes for even which are used for external application for prickly heat. Okay, if you remember, and to dry drying out of wound. So therefore the dust, so these are medicated dusting powder. Basically dusting powder should be passed through a sieve number of 80 or sieve number 120 to enhance their effectiveness. That means the particle size should be very fine particle size. Okay, so dusting powder, as I told, medicated one and surgical dusting powder, both surgical dusting powder and medicated. Surgicals are used during the surgical operations, and medicated dusting powders are used for local wound healing and for other medical conditions associated, right? Now medicated dusting powder. Medicated dusting powders are generally used for superficial skin conditions. Body dusting powders have a wide appeal because of smooth feel and cooling effect which they impart while they temporarily absorb moisture. And cooling effect is due to the extra heat loss due to the large surface area of talc particle. Now surgical dusting powders are intended, they are used into deep layer of the skin, also on major wounds such as a result of burns and umbilical cord of infants. So these are sterilized before use. Okay, and it contains antimicrobial agents, and they are generally prepared by mixing two or more ingredients, one of which must be starch, talc or kaolin as the major ingredient of the formulation. So in the preparation of dusting powder, the talc or kaolin starch are used commonly because they are chemically inert. So what is the use? Okay, so you should know that why these basic ingredients. I told you that one of the ingredients should be either talc, starch, kaolin. Okay, why? Because they are inert. Okay, but ingredients are readily contaminated by pathogenic bacteria, so they must be sterilized before use. By using which method of sterilization? Dry heat sterilization method. So dusting powder, they are dispensed in sifter or in aerosol container. And what is the use? Antiseptic, antiperspirant, absorbent, astringent. So these are the uses. This is the procedure of dusting powder. Weigh accurately all the powders and mix them in ascending order of their weight. Pass the mixed powder through sieve number 85 to 120, and after sieving, mix them lightly and transfer into the sifter top container and protect it from atmospheric contamination. Direction of using dusting powder: applied on the affected part, okay, two times or three times a day based on the prescription. And use zinc oxide is used as an astringent and antiseptic, while salicylic acid it is used as an antiseptic and fungicide. Now, what are the problems? Okay, now the last topic of this module, it is problems encountered in the formulation of powder, hygroscopic and deliquescent powder. Okay, the term hygroscopicity means what? Hygroscopicity means it absorbs the moisture from atmosphere and it leads to partial or complete liquefaction. Okay, so dear students, first understand what hygroscopic is. And deliquescent material which absorbs the moisture from the atmosphere and leads to the partial and complete liquefaction, and this problem is prevented by reducing the surface area exposed to the environment. Okay, so reduction in surface area which is exposed to the environment, which is exposed to moisture, is going to reduce the process of liquefaction. Okay, addition of magnesium dioxide to reduce dumping. Okay, magnesium oxide is added as to prevent the damping. Damping means the damp mass, which we call it as. Okay, so, and by packing in aluminium foil or in plastic film packets, so that it is protected from the outer environment, and by adding the absorbent material such as starch. So these remedial measures we can take while formulating hygroscopic and deliquescent powders. Okay, effervescent powder, it contains the material which reacts in the presence of water and it evolves carbon dioxide. Okay, carbon dioxide. Effervescent granules you might have seen. Okay, the Disprin tablet you have seen, which dissolves, and this class of preparation can be supplied either by compounding the ingredient as granules or dispense in the form of salt. Granules or in the form of salt. Okay, so for evolution of gas, two constituents are essential. What are these? A soluble carbonate such as sodium bicarbonate and an organic acid such as citric acid or tartaric acid. Okay. So the preparation is supplied either as a bulk powder or distributed in individual powders. So effervescent powder, it loses their water of crystallization before hydration or solvated salt to atmosphere on exposure of air. So crystalline substances loses water during storage and causes powder to turn into the liquid or in the form of a paste, because it absorbs little moisture. Okay, so it is converted into paste. So what is the solution? Using the anhydrous form plus treating it in a manner similar to hygroscopic powder by including the drying bulky powder such as stars and magnesium oxide, as I told you. So dear students, it was about the problems encountered in the formulation of powder. Okay, so one more point left. Okay, so let me tell you about eutectic mixtures. Also, that eutectic mixtures are these are mixtures basically of low melting point ingredients, and which on mixing together turn into liquid form. They turn into liquid form due to the depression of melting point of the mixture below room temperature. So this problem is resolved during formulation of powder. Such material is a material can be such materials like inert material absorbent such as starch, talc, lactose are used to prevent the dampness of the powder and dispensing the components of the eutectic mixture separately can solve this problem of eutectic mixtures. Okay, so it was all about the problems in powder formulations. So dear students, let me quickly summarize this module. That in this module we studied about introduction to powders and what are advantages and different advantages, disadvantages of powders and blending of powder, different particle sizes and effect of those particle sizes, classification of powder, okay, and the what are different classes based on their uses and problems encountered in powder formulation. Okay, so dear students, I hope you enjoyed this module, and this is a very important topic for your exam point of view also. So just go through from this topic. I'm sure that you will learn about powder very quickly. So that's all for this module, and stay tuned for more videos, and thank you so much for watching this video.